Belinda and ABC Audio present this unabridged recording of Itch, from showrunner Amanda Morrison, created by Melanie Halsall and developed by Dan Belinka. Written by Melanie Halsall, Dan Belinka, Heather Wilson, Ron Elliott, Jessica Brookman, and Roger Monk. Music by Diego Baldenweg, with Nora Baldenweg and Lionel Baldenweg. The recording is adapted from the audio of the TV series produced by Comics Entertainment Productions, in association with Feisty Dame Productions, and is based on the book by Simon Mayo, and read by full cast.
Hi, I'm Itch. In case you're wondering what kind of a name Itch is, it's short for Itchingham. Itchingham aloft, international man of mystery, science extraordinaire.
I think you mean dork who collects junk.
Chloe, get out of my room. For the record, I don't collect junk. I collect elements, just like the ones on the periodic table. Which brings me to the story of how I had the wildest summer of my life, all thanks to my element collection. So sit back, relax, and get ready to hear the greatest action-packed adventure in the history of science.
You are such a nerd.
Chloe! I said get out!
Having a laugh, mate. I don't need a permit to park my caravan in this quarry. I am doing vital scientific work. There's something special about the ground beneath Seaburg. I've been studying. Whoa! Hi! Are you feeling that where you are, mate? The whole quarry shook.
Going to be another sunny week in Seaburg with no sign of a repeat of last month's freaky earthquake. Speaking of earthquakes, we've got nothing but non-stop music to shake up your day.
Itch, I asked you to empty the dishwasher.
In a minute. I'm just in the middle of something.
Okay, sodium oxide, element Na2O, only mildly dangerous. Okay, maybe not mild, but if Benjamin Franklin had ever said, maybe I shouldn't attach this kite to this key during a lightning storm, we wouldn't have discovered electricity. Now, where was I? Yeah, two parts, element H. Oh, cool.
Itch!
Sorry, Mum.
What is wrong with you?
Nothing, Mum. Maybe singed my hair a bit, that's all.
A bit?
Yeah, but and I did a really cool experiment.
I don't care about your experiment. You nearly blew up the house. I thought it was another earthquake.
Mum, it was nothing like an earthquake. Earthquakes are caused by tectonic plates moving within the Earth's gravitational field. Explosions happen when energy is suddenly released in the form of heat.
Stop. Itch. You could have killed us all.
The blast radius was nowhere near big enough.
No more experiments in the house. I'm going to have to speak to your dad about this.
Is he coming home?
Just go down to the beach until the smoke clears. I'll send your sister down too.
Playing with your rocks?
Elements.
Mum says you're going to have to pay for the damage to your room.
Already paying. Stuck in this nowhere town, going to a school where everyone hates me.
You could try being less, you know, you. Try and fit it a bit, kick a ball around, talk about video games, anything other than collecting elements. Who does that?
Lots of people collect things.
Yeah, footy cards or action figures, or even stamps, not rocks and junk.
I just like knowing what everything's made of. See, this is quartz, granite, sandstone.
Shh. No one cares.
Dad does.
Only because it's his job. She phoned him. They just had a huge fight, again, about your behavior, again. Where are you going?
To the markets,
for science class. So if Mum asks where I am, you can tell her I'm doing schoolwork.
Mr. Lannister, it's Roshana. I'm at the old mine site now. Radiation levels are definitely up since the earthquake. Yes, we'll keep looking. I've got my best people on it. Rat, I need to get another team down here doing Geiger readings. You keep an eye on that hippie who's been sniffing around.
Got it, boss.
And there is your $5 change. Okay, see ya.
Hi, Cake.
How's business?
Oh, hey, mate. Yeah, can't complain. How's the element hunting going? Did you manage to make sodium from that bit of marble you bought the other day?
Kinda, but it almost set my bedroom on fire.
Well, that was not the intended purpose when I sold it to you. Cake Enterprises accepts no liability for damages incurred due to irresponsible use of our merchandise.
Okay, I'm not planning to sue. Just came to find something for my science class.
Yeah, well, in that case, have a browse. I got some new bits and pieces.
Any gunpowder? Just for the sulfur.
No. And I thought you'd have enough of explosives.
Fair point. How much for these?
That roll of wallpaper's vintage.
Yeah, I can tell. If it's proper old...
It is.
...then it might have arsenic in the dye. And I'll have another element to add to my collection.
And the clock?
Says 1910 on the back. Hands look luminous. I reckon it's coated in radium.
Bang on, mate. You know your apples from your elements.
Ah, cheers. But shouldn't you keep this in like a lead-lined container or something? You know, because it's radioactive.
Not in the small amount that's on that clock. No more radioactive than a banana.
Elements 88 and 33.
Rat.
Go ahead.
It's Jojo. I'm at the beach market. Cake has the rock.
Make sure you get it.
So, how much for the clock and the wallpaper?
What?
How much?
Let's just say 40.
Ah, that'll clean me out. How about you throw in this rock?
Yeah, that's not really for sale.
What is it? Why is it so hot?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I thought it was uranium, you know, because of the heat, but it doesn't look anything like it.
Where'd you get it?
I found it after the earthquake. Turned up all sorts of odds and ends at the old mines.
Maybe I can test it in one of the labs at school.
Oh, yeah, take it.
See you later.
Yeah, I'll see you.
Element 88 and 33. Only need another... 53 elements to get everything on the periodic table.
Hey! My bag! Give it back!
I said, give it back!
Are you okay? Do I need to call the police?
No, I'm fine. He didn't get my bag.
Did you see his face?
No.
Mum says lights out.
Tell her they are.
I can see they're not. Come on, guys. It's late.
What's that? Another rock? Is that for your science class?
Maybe. Don't know what it is yet. And I nearly lost it as soon as I got it. I had to chase down some guy in a hoodie who snatched my bag on the way home. Yeah, that's right. I heroically defended my property.
Who'd want your moldy old rock?
Probably thought there was a laptop in my bag. But we didn't really discuss it. He hasn't sent me a friend request.
Ha ha.
The rock. It's still warm.
It's kind of glowing.
Great. Another day surrounded by jocks, cool kids, and everyone but me hanging out with their friends.
Ouch!
Oh, Lucy! Sorry.
Way to go. You just bumped into the most popular girl in school.
My mind was somewhere else.
That's okay. How are you?
Me? I'm good. Good.
Darcy!
Great. Darcy, captain of the handsome jocks. What does Lucy see in him?
Morning, Rash.
Rash?
Oh, I get it. Because my name's Itch.
Good one.
Get going.
Yep.
Darcy!
Babe, that guy's so weird.
Hey, Jack. Oh, you're getting really good.
Better be. Grading's next month. Gotta keep practicing my patterns. What are you doing in the gym at lunch? Who are you hiding from?
No one.
You gotta learn to stand up for yourself.
I'm not a taekwondo champion.
Yeah, but tell him your cousin is.
I don't think getting you to fight my battles is gonna be the answer.
I better get changed. My next lesson's with you, right? Geography?
Double science.
No. Really? Oh, man. In that hot, sticky greenhouse? I thought that was tomorrow.
Well, today.
You don't have to look so keen.
I like science, and I've got something I want to ask Flower Dew about.
Redecorating tips?
No, not that. Although, it is interesting. It's antique wallpaper, so it has arsenic in it. But no, I want to show him this rock.
Hold up. Back up to when you said something that sounded like arsenic.
It's just a wallpaper dye. The Victorians used arsenic to get this certain shade of green.
Itch, you can't be bringing poison into the school.
It's for my element collection. Don't worry, there's not enough here to be dangerous.
Okay, quiet everyone. Today we're going to be carrying on our work on the periodic table. And we're in this greenhouse because...
You like torturing us with this heat?
Well, yes, Jack. But there is another reason. Darcy?
Because there's elements in plants.
True, there are many. But today we're going to be looking at how elements affect plant growth. I know, it's a riveting subject. So to wake us all up in this sweltering heat, you each have a worksheet in front of you, and the first one to finish will win one of my wine cups.
Does he think we're still in kindergarten?
He's just mad because you never win any wine gums.
Oh, stupid heat. I don't feel good.
Dr. Flowerdew?
Yes.
I found this and wondered if you'd seen anything like it before. I don't know what it is.
It's a rock.
Yeah, I know. But I think it's also an element. It's hot like uranium, but it looks nothing like it.
A hot rock. But then everything's warm in here.
No, it's always hot. It hasn't lost any heat since I got it.
Well, that's unusual. Where'd you get it?
From a junk stall at the market. I thought it might be an element, but I'm not sure which.
Whoa! I'm not feeling good either.
If you're not feeling well, you need to get outside. All right, everybody out. Outside, everyone. Everybody outside.
Lucy, are you all right? Do you need some water or something?
She doesn't need any help from you, mate.
Well, I was just trying to... Get back, will ya? You just threw up on me!
Sorry. Everyone outside, now!
You okay? You gonna be sick?
Be rude not to.
Dr. Flowerdew, you don't think...
Hmm?
My rock...
What if it's radioactive, you know, because it's so warm? Could that be what made everyone sick?
I don't know, but we're going to find out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.